Hello, this is Chris, and welcome to another aviation video on Flight Sim. Today, we're going to talk about Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Good, bad, stay tuned. Alright, everybody, welcome on board Flight Deck. Today we're in the Captain Sim 757. Not very many people use this add-on. It's fine. That's all I have to say. I really like the 757 as a plane, so. Yeah, I just really like the 757 on as a plane, so which is why we're going to be using it. Don't need that. That's just a test, I think. Yeah, so that's what we're doing. We're on the 757 today. We're at Minneapolis Air International Airport. Jetways are still kind of weird. I'll have to look into that. I think I know how to fix that, so we should be fine with those. But yeah, we have the prep complete, and we're just waiting for the pushback. So we can go ahead and shut the door. You know, you can say what you want about the 757, but there are very few planes in P3D that have this high quality of a cabin. There are a few planes, even an X-plane, with that high quality of a cabin. That's kind of different for X-plane. Look, you can. I don't know if that does something, but. Yeah, this is gonna be nuts. So, yeah. Going to Minneapolis. Or Minneapolis, Detroit. We've featured Minneapolis quite a few times on this channel. Never Detroit, though, so that's gonna be an interesting one to try. Why is that open? Yeah. Never featured Detroit before, which is a shame because it's a really nice scenery over there. Whoever they are, I forget the name escapes me. It's practically free, and it's like practically this quality scenery. So, pretty excited to try that out. Hope you guys are too. See what it's like. New departing off of 12 right at Minneapolis today. The Colt 6. Something actually did go a little strange with our route, so we'll have to deal with that when we get a little bit closer to Detroit. But basically, this plane has a a outdated FMC, and Detroit recently updated their SIDs and stars. So I have none of the stars that are currently available. So we're gonna have to figure out which star I want to use. I have tried to update it, but it says it's updated in the nav graph, Navigraph. So I'm gonna have to see if there's a way to like manually update it or get it to figure out why. But I just figured we'd go ahead and record this video. I was gonna do it on VATSIM, but as it turns out, everything's broken, so we're not. We haven't been able to go on VATSIM last while because everything has been, guess what, broken. So I'm gonna try and get on VATSIM for the next video. That's the plan, at least. Because Vatsim's awesome, right? All right, engine number two. We can get everything fired up then. We'll look into that later, and then we can get to the main topic of the video, which is Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. All right, there's 20%. This plane has been updated semi-recently. There's a lot more sounds and stuff. So that's pretty nice. And hopefully, I haven't tried it yet, but hopefully it flies a little bit better. Because this plane and the Aerosoft A330 probably are the worst handling planes in the world. They're both way too sensitive. Yeah, just way too sensitive. This plane really does go all over the place. You really shouldn't be able to do that with a 757. But that's how Captain Sim did it. And I really do like Captain Sim, not from a they're good at what they do standpoint, from a nostalgia standpoint. Captain Sim was, well, the first ever add-on I got was for Flight Sim X, and it was a PMDG 737, but I couldn't figure out how to use it. So no, it wasn't actually. It was a Captain Sim. I lied. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, so. The first plane I got was a Captain Sim.
Set parking brakes.
It was either this plane, the 757, or the 7.
Waiting your confirmation for good engine.
6.7 or the 777, but I got those two. Those are the first three I got, and then I got the PMDG afterwards. I used to fly those like crazy, especially the 777. Even though looking at it now, it's, you know, it's not that great, but I really liked it. So I was really excited to see that they'd come back and they'd revamped the 757, because I also flew that thing a lot. And, you know, this is, it looks a lot better in P3D, obviously, left and right. And it's overpriced, especially the 767. It's $135 normal, so there's not a chance I'm going to get that. I forgot to do that. Especially with Flight Sim coming out. Which is a good segue to our next topic, or the main topic, which I really wanted to talk about, because the flight is, it's okay. It's not, to be honest, it's not that interesting of a flight. We're just going to Detroit, which is just a random airport from another random airport that we've featured a bunch of times on the channel. So, I figured we'd talk about the new Microsoft Flight Simulator. I know we've been lauding of information coming out about that in recent days with all the better streamers and content creators getting the pre-build version, pre-release version, whatever it's called. What's going on there? I just wanted to share my thoughts and let you know what I thought about the new simulator. Not that anybody cares, but just in case. Okay, see, where is this taxi place? Oh, it's down there. Okay, we're good. Yeah, so I figured I would I'd give my thoughts. So, as we all know, it's a fantastic plane. Plane? It's not a plane. It's a game. It's a completely new simulator, and it looks just.
Left is clear. Right is clear.
It looks insane. Like, especially, yeah, it looks, you know, 10 out of 10. Like, you know, you can't really rival it, because it's literally like Google Earth, but like Bing, but just imported straight in. It's like the Google Earth flight simulator, but not sucky. Gonna blind them there. Yeah, so it's just insane that how it looks. And the clouds and everything and the whatever. I know I phrased this like, oh, I'm gonna hate on it, because like, oh, what does he think? Maybe that was clickbait-ish. Well, I mean, I am gonna get my thoughts. I never said which way they'd go. But the point is, yeah, I'm a huge fan of what they've got going there at Asobo. I think a lot of us got our expectations. I don't know about a lot of us. I did. When we first got it announced, my expectations were. Whoa! Okay, that was the wrong button. Sorry about that, guys. Yeah, my expectations were too high. I was expecting, like, the 320 Neo and the 7478 to be, you know, perfect aircraft. I've come to realize now that that's not true. I started to realize that a while ago. Because, I mean, realistically, it's impossible to develop that good of a plane that quickly. I just figured because they got, you know, everything else looking so amazing that they'd get that one too perfectly. But thinking back on it now, that was kind of a naive way to think about it. But, I mean, I want to do like a tutorial series on the YouTube channel, kind of walking people through, like, you know, from first learning how to fly a Cessna all the way up to flying an airliner. And I don't think I'll be able to use those airliners to, like, you know, properly demonstrate what it's like to fly an airliner, because, you know, it's not really how it is. Like, the footage I've seen, it, you know what I mean, like, it's not, if everyone has the FS Labs or the Flight Factory or the TOLUS or even the Aerosoft, you know that's not how an A320 flies. Like, you know, the PFD looks all weird, the panel looks a little weird, you know, it just doesn't fly right. So, you know, I'm not happy about that. I hoped it would be a little bit better, but I don't care, really. We've got third-party add-ons. Hopefully they don't take too long. It seems like Asobo's made a fairly interactive, intuitive, I should say, development SDK for the devs. So it should be okay. Hopefully, I know PMDG already has pictures, so you know they've been hard at work. So you know when you get the PMDG 737, all that stuff, you know we'll be golden. But until then, I'm still a huge fan because I like GA planes. I'm in flight training right now, so I don't know if that would help bolster my opinion of them. But you know they're just a blast. Like flying, you know, like a Cessna 152 or 172 into like you know tiny little bush airports, like that's the bomb. So, huh? That's new. I guess we'll take off with a higher trim setting. You know, I probably should be doing that, but who cares? We'll just pitch forward. That's just fantastic in my opinion. The fact that they have so many GA planes too. Like I plan on getting the Premium Deluxe so far is what my plan is. I've been a little bit hesitant because what you really be getting is the SR-22 is really what you're paying and the sceneries. I don't know if the 787 and you know you get like some weird aerobatic plane and some like light sport plane, but it's really you know I'm not gonna use those a lot, but. You know, it's just a matter of, I have some money, but I don't know if I want to save it for the third-party developers, see when they get their stuff out. But again, I could be setting my expectations too high, because who knows when they'll come out, the third party. So I'm probably going to get that, and you know, you guys will get a more comprehensive look my opinions when the thing comes out. I know it is really just speculation at this point, but you know we're taking off, you know, 80 knots either for pressure, press check, fire set 100 here. Yeah, I'll do this takeoff, then I'll get back to my points. It still throttles down during the take. It seems like it does it less, but well, maybe it's fine. Okay, see. Okay, we're up. That should not be happening. Bumpy. Oh, is that the test I put on or something? I don't know why that's red. Okay. The Mall of America should be right there. I know I point it out every time I depart out of Minneapolis, but it's a pretty cool place. Can do the direct. And where will that take us? That'll take us this way. How do I get rid of... there. Weather. Okay. We should be accelerating now. Oh yeah, because VNAV doesn't work. There we go. There is acceleration. Throw in the autopilot. No, boy. That's what I want. Flap 5. I think that's flap 5. Yes. Flap 1. And flap up. Alright, we're clean. On our way to Chicago. Nope, going to Detroit. Spending a lot of time in the north of the United States. We'll have to go to Europe again sometime soon, because Europe is pretty cool, right? Accelerating nicely. We can climb up to 350. But yeah, in terms of Microsoft Flight Simulator, I'm very excited for the GA planes. Like, the airports, I can't wait, you know, to find my house. Everyone is excited for that, I assume. But I really can't wait to fly into... I want to do, like, a tour around some part of the United States, just because it's so cool. And just kind of fly around and, you know, just see what's going on. See how everyone's doing. See what the, you know, what's going on. You know, like, just fly around, fly in these small airports. I want to take, like, you know, the Cessna or maybe the Cirrus or a Baron or you know, maybe one a citation or something, and just it's going to be fantastic. And when we get third party develop stuff, you know, the hype is high. It's not as much as it was like 2 months ago, I'm going to be honest, but it's still very high. Like, you know, it's very little they could do to disappoint. If they don't have a replay system, which I'm definitely worried about, that's going to be a huge negative. Like, replays are very important to me. I don't know why. Just, like, looking at my landings. Yeah, they better have a replay system. That's... because I've been a little worried, because they haven't had that. I've heard bad things about the camera system. Who cares? It's for the longest time, I used the FSX default camera system, and I got by just fine, so... Yeah. I don't know, dude. Here, let's put in... Detroit is not in your database. There, that'll help just, what, did I set my cruise altitude wrong? 350 is what we want, right? Yeah, okay, we're good. Alright, yeah, we're through 10K now. So, I'll have to go work out our arrival situation, and I'll talk to you guys to get a little bit closer, and I'll give the rest of my thoughts at the new flight sim. So I'll see you guys when we get, close to the top of drop. How's it going, everybody? Welcome back on board the Captain Sim. So, I have a solution to our star problem, and it looks like that, which looks a lot like our routing. So, here, if I pull up our route here, that looks virtually identical. So what my theory is that they just I think I paused there for a second accidentally. You might have automatically pausing at top of descent, but yeah, so my theory is that they just renamed the stuff. So that's all cool. We can see what our landing's gonna be like. 240 at 6 is the wind. So that would put us down. 2406 would put us down on runway 31. Or the 27, I don't think they land there. So we'll plan on... oh, there is no 31. 240, that'll be 21. So we'll plan... we'll plan on 2-1 left. Yeah, let's plan 2-1 left. And here, I will also go ahead and show the chart for that. So 2-1 left, we're gonna come in this way, hopefully vacate by Whiskey 2, and then it'll just be a matter of, we could take Juliet back up, and we're going into the Alpha gates, which are right here, which is where Delta parks. So we could just roll out all the way and exit Juliet, and just take the straight route down to the taxi. That might be the easiest way of getting to our place. We could land 2-1 right, but I think they use that for departures. It's just easier to land a little further away from everything, and it's actually a little more straightforward of a taxi instead of getting off like Mike 3, then going up Fox, and then going that way. If you're parking on this end, it might actually wind up be quicker, but all depends on how we roll out. That's the plan. Alpha 66 is the gate, so we'll find out where that leads us. I think it's time to start headed down. Yeah. So we can, let's see. Rip. Sorry, guys. There we go. We can set, 150. I think it's kind of messed up here. Yeah. So... ah, that's why. So we want to be proceeding direct to butter, which is what we are going to do on this landing. We are going to butter the bread. Oh, jeez. Oh, are we slowing down or something? Oh, no. Why are we... OK, Okay, let's start a descent. How about that? Huh. There, descend now. See, now that'll... See, this plane works most of the time. Just most. We'll go auto brake one. We'll go flap 25 for the landing. And plug in 1115. Oh, nope, that goes... No, that's auto, so we don't need to plug in anything. Okay, cool. It should be in level change. So yeah, Butter is supposed to be at 220. And at Scooby, which is where we enter the downwind, we're 8,000. Let's see if this helps it. I was gonna let you guys go. I will let you guys go. Kind of think you guys want to watch me faff around at this piece of trash. So, bye. Alright, everybody, welcome back. I've just started to self-vector us in for the ILS runway 21 right. So, we can actually do 120 in the heading. Just like last video, we are extremely high. So, you know what that means. Well, for starters, that means 250 knots. I don't think this one will be doable like the last one. Actually, I thought we were coming in the other way, so I was more lenient with the speed. I just now realized that, so good time to come back, folks. I was going to talk a bit more about the new flight sim, but things have actually gotten quite busy. You know. Yeah. But in general, in regards to the new flight sim, huge fan, huge fan. I can't wait to be getting the you know, the Cessna and flying through weather and crap, and, you know, it's crap. It's not gonna work. In general, yeah, that's gonna be, it's gonna be so much fun. I really can't wait. This isn't gonna work, is it? Yeah, no. We are at 250 knots. Coming in on final. Well, I keep getting high. I don't know how this keeps happening. Sorry. I really shouldn't be looking away this fast. This much. Flap 1, we need 240 knots for flap 1. Why is the throttle that high? We're in level change, are we not? Oh, we're at 4,000. Okay, here, let's go down to 3. And let's try and be imaginative. So let's, how do we do this? Let's swing it around. We can bring the speed down. We can get rid of that. We can bring, let's bring it down to 180 knots. And then we'll bring out flaps as so. Yeah, we'll do a 360. Check. Yeah, so in general, with Flight Sim 2020, I could be more excited, which is kind of just reiterating what I said beforehand. But yeah, it's gonna be fan. I can't wait. We're gonna do some, you know, we're gonna be flying around in GA planes. We're gonna be, just make sure we do max bank. You know, we'll do an auto actually. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. Here, let's fly 090 just for a little bit. Yeah, I also wanted, guys, I wanted to mention this. The new video, as of recording, we just premiered the Golden Gate Bridge departure video, the 787 video. It has 29 views. It's not even been 6 hours. It's been 6 hours. So I could not be more happy. Well, I mean, if it had 29 million views, I would be. But, you know, realistically speaking, this is insane. This is much better than any of my videos have done ever. So, yeah, I really couldn't be happier. This has been very, very, very exciting to get these type of views. To see one of my videos actually doing, you know, not horribly. So, you know, really appreciate it. We'll see how the Chicago one does and the New York one. Those haven't been released yet, from the recording date. And we'll see how this one goes. Flat 15. But yeah, I would very much like to thank you guys for... And we'll see what this one's at when this video gets released. You know, it could be something higher than that. Who knows what could happen. This is, you know, this is pretty nuts. So, yeah, thanks for the support. Hope you guys continue to enjoy the content. And, you know, I'll keep making it. Could try and do some other type of videos. They don't all have to be full flight videos. I said in the Chicago one that I would start posting like highlights from the videos. Upon second thought, I don't know if I'm going to do that. Not really. I'm not trying to, you know, be lazy or sound lazy. It's just it's not that hard. It'd take me 3 minutes. But this is a really weird approach we're doing. But in general, the full flight videos, like, had we not had a go around in our... What's it doing? What's it doing? We're landing 2 on right. No, we're not. We're landing 2 on left. Ah! I knew that. Gear down. Yeah, I'm very happy. Get down to 160. Sorry about that. Assume 4,000 to go around. And yeah, this plane also landing not the most fun. So, just to let you guys know. Bring it all the way down in speed to our final approach speed. 137.
1,000.
Flaps 30. Or flaps 25. And speed brake armed. Auto throttle. Autopilot. Let's get a nice butter to round off the day. Or round off the video. You know, this is a very... Most of my landings in this plane are good, but there are fewer times it's not been good. This is an interesting plane to land. It definitely seems a little less sensitive than before. I don't know if that's just a me thing, or... I haven't actually flown this plane in a while, so... This could be a me thing, but it seems... You know... Seems a little more stable than last time. I could be just making that up. I probably am. Got 2 reds, 2 whites. It seems like an awfully high pitch to just maintain. Here, we'll pitch for the pappies and not continue. Not the glide slope.
100.
Get back on that center line.
50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
All right. Welcome to Detroit, everybody. Gently with the nose, and then we can just let it roll out. We have idle reverse out. 1 hour and 11 minutes of flight time. That was quick. And I don't know what taxiway that was. Hope that wasn't Juliet. Okay, good. I don't think it... Oh, was? That might have been. Who knows? We'll get the next one, whichever one that may be. Okay. Get rid of the reversers. I think this is Juliet. Alright. We can exit out now. Let's get a little bit more, a little bit of power in. Want to keep it moving. Don't want to be dilly-dallying on the runway. Wait, why are my brakes on? Wait, are the auto brakes still on? Why is it registering with brakes? That's interesting. Disarm. Oh well. I don't know if it's like kind of registering my... Oh well, it doesn't seem to be affecting anything. Anywho, you can get rid of the speed brakes, you can get the flaps up. Welcome to Detroit, everybody. And this is Juliet we got off on, so that's good. It's just, my feet are completely off my rudder pedals, so... I guess we can just taxi with a little extra power. Oh well. That's kind of annoying. Okay. Just make sure that... Okay. That is really annoying. Why do I have to have 50% power just to drive? Try that? No? Oh well. It's not that long of a taxi. Everything up there we can off. Please stay on the runway. Yeah, look at all that power just to maintain like 16 knots. It says differential braking too. Like if I just MFG. Yeah, I don't know where the thing is. I'd have a look if I could, but we're basically there. A66 or Alpha 66. It's the. Please don't be too small. Too small. Okay. Well, we'll take. We'll figure it out when we get there. What was that? Something just disconnected. Always something, isn't there? Always something. Hey, at least we got off where we wanted to. It's weird, because the brakes are registering in the air. What's happening here? One of my cables must be loose. That's probably what's causing this. Bing, bing. Gotta keep the power on, because and yeah, the jetways are a little weird here too. But anyway, let's have a look at the landing rate, shall we? Minus 132. That's like the exact same landing rate as in, as the Dreamliner video and the, A330 video, so yes, I'm consistent. Better than the minus 600 I had into LaGuardia, or 800. That was minus 800. We don't speak of that. Okay, well, we don't want to be going Mach 5. You want to get going. So now it seems like, yeah, there's definitely some brake in. Because you don't decelerate that quickly with no brake. Anywho, yeah, that was a good flight. And that's what I think about Microsoft Flight Sim. And that is what I think about the world. Well, A40, when you keep going a bit. Yeah, as much as a plane would not want us to keep going, we're going to keep going. I don't know if there's something that is like wanting to brake or something. Like, I can push down. Is it one of the... Like if I push, I put. So my left brake just isn't working. Okay, I'll have to have a look at that in a later, in a second. A56. I think this is where we want to go, right before the heavies, right after the heavies. Is A64 acceptable? Maybe it thinks you're a heavy. Yeah. Okay, so we're just gonna, we'll... No, I don't want that. I definitely don't want that. We'll pull in right here at A60. Sorry about this weird stuff going on the ground. Anywho. Yeah. It's definitely something. Alright guys, we'll pull it in here, then we'll get some replays going, then we'll send you guys on your way to enjoy the rest of whatever you are gonna do. Alright, we'll just kind of throw it in here. We don't have GSX because it doesn't like us. That was horrible brake stopping, but who cares? We've made it. Complete the flight. There's our route. There's our little 360 we did, you can see. Whoop! But we made it in. That's what matters. Came off at the point we wanted to. A little bit long of a landing. I've been landing kind of long, and I'd like to maybe cease that behavior. The A330 video didn't land long, but this one, my seventh, yeah, I need to stop landing long. We need to get in the Airbus. Kind of thunk it in there. I don't know what video we'll do next. I don't know. What do you guys think? I record these so far in advance, you guys actually won't be able to really see. So, I record these in chunks and then release them. Like, I've recorded two videos today so far. I might do a third long haul overnight. Long hauls seem to do well, though, so. Yeah, I might do more long hauls. Look at that. Just floating it out, floating it out. We did flare maybe just a touch bit high. But I don't wanna smash it. Let's have a look at the other wing. We can back it up just a little bit. Here, let's look from back here. Then we just kind of slowly settled it in. There we go. Good stuff. Have one more view of the from the inside. Can look at. Let's look over here. There we go. Came in nice and straight. Little left to center, but this thing is a little touchy with the roll. Kind of like the Aerosoft. So what can you really do? You can see we're kind of moving the ailerons. There we go, over the top, power comes out. Then we just kind of let it settle in. There it goes. Okay, let's have a look at the tower view. I don't know why a lot, oh, this is a very nice tower view. I don't know why a lot of people don't like the you know, replays in PPV. This is perfect, except the FS Lab isn't great for replays, but this plane and like the quality wings, this plane especially is probably the best in terms of replays. FS Lab the worst, but you know, look at that. Ooh, it looks good. It might not be smooth. It's not the smoothest landing, but it looks good. You know what I mean? It looks like, you know, what it's meant to look like. Just kind of came down nicely, nice and slow. Touchdown. Let's see, can I get a 2-2 left? Oh yeah. Except I want 2-1 left. I don't know when it's gonna show up. Moment of truth. Over the top, and there we go. Just let it settle in. See, it did kind of drift a little bit to the left. Touchdown. And the nose comes down. And then we do that. Alright guys, that's gonna be it. So like, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Please rate or comment to this video. Once again, thank you for watching. See you next time. And bye.